Hello students, myself Ganesh B. Agalave, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So in the this fourth session of fins, we'll see fin with insulated end. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to derive equation for fin with insulated end. This is our second. This is the second case. Fin with insulated end. So this is the base surface of the fin. The base temperature T naught, surrounding temperature T infinity. In a few applications, so what is observed? In comparison with the length of the fin, the end is very, very thin. So we can assume the end to be adiabatic, means insulated. Insulated. So in this case, the boundary conditions will be at x is equal to 0, theta is equal to theta naught, and second boundary condition at x is equal to L, d theta by dx would be 0, as the temperature gradient is 0. Now try to recall the general heat conduction equation. Yes. So it is theta is equal to C1 e raised to mx plus C2 e raised to minus mx. In the previous case, already we got the constant, that is C1, by substituting theta naught is equal to C1 e raised to mx, after substituting it becomes 1 plus C2. Suppose this is the first equation. Now what I will do now here, I will differentiate the general heat conduction equation. So it becomes d theta by dx is equal to m C1 e raised to mx minus m C2 e raised to minus mx. Now if I put the condition, that is d theta, substituting the second boundary condition, applying the second boundary condition, that is d theta by dx at x is equal to L will become equal to m C1 e raised to ml minus m C2 e raised to minus ml. Already we know this equation, the temperature gradient at L, x is equal to L, is 0. So I can write this as 0 is equal to m C1 e raised to ml minus m C2 e raised to minus ml. I can take this on left hand side, mm will get cancelled. So I can write a C1 e raised to ml is equal to C2 e raised to minus ml. I can get the constant C1, which is equal to C2 into e raised to minus ml divided by e raised to ml, which will become equal to C2 e raised to minus 2 times ml. So this is the C1 constant. If I now substitute the C1 in equation A, substituting C1 in equation A, general heat conduction equation, general heat conduction equation. So theta will be equal to the C1 is C2 e raised to minus 2 ml. This is the replacement of C1 into e raised to mx plus C2 e raised to minus mx. So this theta would become equal to C2 e raised to minus 2 ml plus mx plus C2 e raised to minus mx. Now I can write this as theta can take C2 common into bracket substituting C1 in equation 1. I can write this is C1 substituting in this equation 1. I can write theta naught is equal to C1 plus C2. So what is C1? C1 is C2 e raised to minus 2 ml plus C2. So this theta naught will become C2 into bracket e raised to minus 2 ml plus 1. So C2 is nothing but theta naught by e raised to minus 2 ml plus 1. Now here I can divide numerator and denominator by e raised to minus ml. So C2 dividing the numerator by e raised to minus ml and denominator e raised to minus 2 ml plus 1 by e raised to minus ml. The simplification will be theta naught into e raised to ml divided by e raised to minus ml plus e raised to plus ml. This will be the relation for C2. Now we have C2 I can substitute this C2 in relation for C1. So since C1 is equal to C2 into e raised to minus 2 ml and C2 is nothing but a theta naught into e raised to ml divided by e raised to minus ml plus e raised to ml. This is nothing but C2 into e raised to minus 2 ml. So this is equal to theta naught into e raised to minus ml divided by e raised to minus ml plus e raised to ml. So we got the equations of constant, that is C2 and C1. Now we can substitute these constants in equation 1. So equation 1 becomes theta naught is equal to C1 is theta naught into e raised to minus m to be substituted in general heat conduction equation. So, theta will become equal to theta naught into e raised to minus ml divided by e raised to ml plus e raised to minus ml into e raised to mx. This is C1. Then C2 is plus C2 is theta naught e raised to ml by plus ml into minus ml into e raised to minus mx. Now, so this theta, I can take theta naught common, will be equal to now e raised to m into bracket x minus l by e raised to ml plus e raised to minus ml plus e raised to m l minus x by e raised to ml plus e raised to minus ml. If you simplify this, then we'll get the temperature distribution equation as theta by theta naught is equal to hyperbolic cos of m l minus x by hyperbolic cos of ml. So, this is the temperature distribution equation for fin with insulated end. Similarly, if you try for the rate of heat conduction for fin with insulated end, Q becomes equal to square root of HP Ka theta naught into hyperbolic tan of ml. So, these are the two equations, temperature distribution equation and rate of heat transfer from the fin with for further study, you can refer to fundamentals of heat and mass transfer by Incropera David.